You may remember some time ago I made a video on how to turn blank values into zero values in Power BI. If you haven't seen it, there's a link to it in the video description. Anyway, a few of you left comments on how this doesn't work for matrix visuals. We'll get into why that might be the case in this video, and if so, how we can go about fixing it. Now bear with me, we might touch on some tricky subjects here. Don't be afraid to re-watch parts of this video or reread the articles that I link to in this video if you need to. Now with that said, let's head over to Power BI and take a look at the problem. So here I'm looking at some football data, and I'm looking at the amount of home goals scored by home team and referee. Now in football, some referees don't take part in some teams' games, so we can expect to see blanks in here as there are. I have a measure here named home goals. Going by my previous video, we can just add plus zero to the measure, and the blanks should all turn to zero. But you can see that they actually don't. So why is that? To explain this, we need to take something called filter context into account. Now I won't go through this whole article because filter context is a long and complex subject, but I want to look at a specific part of this article. Under the hood, Power BI is calculating a formula that looks a little bit like this. So imagine there's a matrix visual here. It has the brand from the product on one axis and the year from a date table on another. If we look at the paragraph below, essentially what this is saying is that the measure will only be calculated where there is a combination of brand and year. If there isn't one, it'll be left with no value. It won't even add the plus zero. So why did my original version work? Well, the simple answer is that the columns on the axis were from two different dimension tables. Therefore, a combination of these can always be generated, and so a value will be calculated. If you're just using one fact table and wanting to use two columns that have no combinations in the data, you'll encounter the same issue that we've discussed. So how do we resolve this? Well, the most simple way for us is to create two dimensions in addition to the fact table that we already have. First, let's head into the data view and create a new table called referee. This will contain the distinct list of referees from the fact table. Then we create another new table called home team, which will be a distinct list of all of the home teams in our data. We then want to head into the model view to create joins between our tables. We want to create a join between the referee table and the results table on the referee column. So we drag from one to the other. We then want to do the exact same thing using the home team column and the home team table. Finally, we head back into the matrix visual. And instead of having the dimension columns be taken from the fact table, we take them from our newly created dimension tables instead. And you can see that the zeros have now been inputted. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.